Wishing you all God's grace and blessings. We will be learning about the women saints in this whole month of November. Many must be wondering why only women. Simply because we are doing it from the Women's Commission. So, story of a woman saint, each day a life story to help us learn and grow more in God's love. Most often we think the saints were too holy to imitate because we always look at them in a very high place, close to God. But by learning about their life stories, we too come to understand that they were also like us once. They too went through all the difficulties, temptations that we go through in our lives today. And they later changed their ways and began to follow Christ. They lived a holy life, and today they wear a glorious crown of sainthood. It's my humble request today not to be scandalized for about the saint that I'm going to share, because the saint we're going to see was once a murderer who killed so many people by taking revenge and retaliation on them. She was so cold-hearted that cruelly tortured so many innocent people, and that saint is Saint Olga of Kiev. She was the first canonized Russian saint. For the revengeful life that she lived, for the murders she committed, nobody ever even thought in her own lifetime that she would become a saint one day. But we all know how God has mysterious ways to touch even the hardest and the coldest hearted people. God's love and mercy has so much of power even to melt the stony hearts. That is how God intervened in the life of Saint Olga and converted her into Christianity. Olga's birth date is unknown. It could be early as 890 AD and as late as 925 AD. Olga was probably of Varangian origin and, according to the primary chronicle, was born in Pleskov. Little is known about her life. Olga was once a princess and first documented female ruler of Russia. When Olga was queen, she placed trading posts, towns and hunting grounds throughout her territories. In effect, she unified Russia into a linked country, rather than a series of disparate towns. Olga could always hatch a multi-step plan. Her husband Igor I was the Prince of Kiev and was assassinated in 1945 by those serving under him. Because of their son was still minor at the time of Igor's death, Olga became the regent of the Grand Principality of Kiev. Seeking revenge against those killed her husband, Olga had Igor's murderers captured and scalded to death. But she wouldn't stop there. She went on to execute hundreds of people who were members of the same tribe as her husband's murderers. She is also said to have ordered the execution of nearly 5,000 men at a feast held in honor. Olga's lowest point. One day, Olga was a beloved queen, wife, and mother. The next, she was a heartbroken widow, single mother, and new regent. And things were not about to get easier. The Drevlians who killed Olga's husband taunted the grieving women with a cruel offer. Olga's bad call. After Igor's death, 20 smug Drevlians rode into town, attempting to intimidate Olga with their might. They saw her at court and proposed an utterly horrific idea. The tribe asked Olga to marry Prince Mal, the same man who had murdered Olga's husband. Olga's life changes. After being touched by the majesty and the awe of the liturgy, Saint Olga was baptized. When Olga returned to Kiev as a changed Christian woman, despite her pagan son's disapproval, after her son took control of the country, Olga requested the appointment of the archbishops and the priests in her dynasty. However, the Holy Roman Emperor refused her request, accusing her of lying and trickery. Despite this, Olga secretly kept a Catholic priest near her at all times, and when she died in 969, her son granted her a Christian burial rather than the pagan celebration. During her lifetime, she sat her beloved son Sviatoslav down and begged him to save his soul by converting. To Olga's despair, her son declined for a pretty wimpy reason. He thought his friends would laugh at him. But later, she succeeded in changing her son, and eventually her grandson later adopted Olga's Christian mantle and declared James Russian Christian. Because of her religious activism, Olga earned a significant honorific title. She is said to be Isa Apostolos, or equal to the apostles. Despite all the darkness, Olga eventually became a saint who protected widows and Christian converts. We conclude with the reflection that this life story helps us to understand, however our past may be, how many maybe we choose to hate and hurt and let our anger, vengeance and retaliation guide us, God has a way to touch even the hardest of hearts. As we read in the book of Prophet Ezekiel 36:26, God says, "A new heart I will give you, and a new spirit I will put within you, and I will remove from your body the heart of stone and give you a heart of flesh, which can love, can forgive, can care, can share and serve others." Today we pray to Saint Olga of Kiev to intercede for all of us, that the good Lord may remove a heart of stone from us which longs to hate, hurt, take revenge and take retaliation on others, but give us a heart of flesh that can love, forgive and care for one another. May our today's prayer be, God, give us a heart of forgiveness, that we may forgive those who we need to forgive today. Amen. This is an initiative from the Catholic Women's Collective, and this video is prepared by Resurrection Church, Indiranagar. Wishing you all a blessed day. Thank you for watching. Amen.